talk very long because I just realized I need to look up my GPS with where I'm going. Where am I going? Well, today is Sunday, the 17th of April, and I am going to a crop out in Sun City with my new friend, Sandy. Sandy, I met at the Scraps of Love Crop Girls store the night that I went out there for a crop. She was there for a crop too, and we both had signed up alone, and we went there and met each other and sat next to each other. And I don't know, we just clicked, and she's just super sweet and nice and everything. So I'm always looking for friends. Anyways, I was going to talk about today what it means for me to be free. And I'm not talking about my country or the soldiers that fight for our freedom or any of that good stuff that a lot of people are referencing to the words free, or even getting something without money. That's not what I'm talking about either. I'm talking about the words free as in the sense of a relationship, as in the sense of a marriage where a husband and wife can either stand alone and independent of each other, and sometimes that's not always good because they may drift further apart, or the other not so good way is where they're too wrapped up into each other's lives that they can't stand on each other on their own. And I remember my father talking to me about this a long time ago. It's like if you are in a relationship and you lean up against somebody in a relationship, whether it be physically or figuratively, if you lean on them, they could probably hold you up for a little while. You know, if I'm leaning on my husband physically, he could probably hold me up. He's strong enough to hold me up for a while. But at some point, he's going to get tired of holding me up. At some point, he's going to be exhausted and frustrated and unable to help me anymore because he needs someone to support him once in a while, especially if he starts to lean the other way or if he starts to become emotional or unstable himself. Who's going to support him if I'm constantly leaning on him? So I thought my father was very smart in giving me that analogy. I was only 16 years old, I think I was. And I don't know, I guess you could say, I was 15 years old. I guess you could say that I've been leaning on Jim for a hell of a long time because I almost felt like he wanted me to, and that was the only way that we could work. He wanted to hold me up and tell me what to do and tell me where to be and tell me where to go. But in honest reality, as I look at this, he didn't want that for me. He wanted me to hold myself up, but basically respect him and his wishes and be there for him. And we kind of do this back and forth thing where I think that's a good healthy balance. I'm not leaning on him too much. He's not leaning on me too much, but we're not too independent from each other that we end up drifting apart. So for me, I've always been very angry and upset with my husband because I always thought he was controlling me and telling me what to do and telling me where to go and telling me what I'm allowed to do and what I'm not allowed to do, and being very controlling and manipulative in an almost abusive way, you know. And I've been reflecting a lot on this and talking about it, whether it be with you at the video camera or my therapist or even just to myself and my husband too. I talked to him about how did I come to this observation. And what it really is that to be free, I'm just going to tell my husband what I'm doing. I'm going to a crop today. I also stopped by McDonald's and I spent some money without asking him if I could spend it. And that's no big deal because he spends money without asking me. And I also got myself something to eat without involving him, without asking him permission, without... And that to me is being free. Being free of my own ties to my dependency on my husband. and being free to my husband's so-called controlling ways, because I don't think I need him to control me, and I don't think he wants to control me. Anyway, that's where that's at. I gotta go check out this GPS thing, because I really don't know where I'm at. And I'll talk to you all later. Bye-bye.